That's gonna be a thing. Use humans. Since the item update, they changed up the element to storm build that I once did. And I had to switch over to my earrings. Before, whatever element you chose, it boosted up every other element. So choosing the weakest element in your roster was beneficial to the ones that you did use. Namely for me, water and fire. And then there's also light damage. So using shadow, since I really don't use it outside of fly swatter, use shadow, boost up the other three. Yeah, I can't do that anymore. They changed up all the earrings. Now it's one per one resistance. Which means it this. The mask from the sub-equipment boosts up even more. Now, on the other hand, I actually did start experimenting. And yes, a witch experimenting, that's something that people fear. Like just, ooh. Anyways, I still managed to get up to 250 water and fire. Except I kinda did something even better. Just look at those numbers go up. So, one of my main things I actually wanted to focus on with the witch in general is my mega drill. Yes, there's a reason why I named her Rogue. But in the process, so for the mega drill, I have the high tech mobility enhancing boots. They increase the command key effect by 400%. Yeah, that's great. Not to mention it gives all element damage too. That's another bonus. Then there's also the technology body cam necklace, which has quick slot skills to increase their attack. Non-quick slot skills reduce their cooldown by 15%. I did have the high tech mobility. Not high tech mobility, what was it called? Unlimited something. I didn't forget what those pants were already. No, not you, I already got you on. How did I forget the name of those pants already? Tactical? No. Seriously, where's my pants? Alright, unlimited cybernetics. This was the one. As my HP drops, my skill cooldown gets reduced as well. Which actually does help out in the long run towards all my skills. But I have my ring, so I'm usually going to stay no more than 50% HP. Another thing is, with the unlimited cybernetic pans, I was still under 250 fire damage. That's where the desert technology pans come in at. I think I had to beat these pans like a baby just to get them. I have to beat the pans off baby. Attacking bird enemies creates an ember. I literally go back into Flame Guard from King's Relic. That's literally what it is. Attacking burn enemies increases fire damage and fire resistance for 5 seconds. Also gets fire damage and every 5 embers I explode. I'm literally Flame Guard. Oh, but here's another one. Yeah, I still got the new one too. Yeah. Restart. Okay, now the puncher bag is no longer on fire. Record. Oh look, it's burning. Yeah, I forgot. That meteor causes it to burn anyway. Let's wait for it to stop burning. Okay, so. Now that it's on fire again, let's have fun with it. I forgot that the meteor does fire damage. Not only fire damage, but it also burns. So I constantly have a source of burning. Outside of lava potion, flame furnace, and mystic. Just on Halloween. Yeah, I have multiple ways to burn meteor. But my favorite one. All those explosions. Yeah, the experiment was a great success. So, with the unlimited cybernetics, my cooldown for the mega drill went from 16 to 15 seconds. Which would be something, but I wanted some more shenanigans instead. I like my mega drill. That's literally my favorite skill on the witch. That's the biggest reason why I named her Rogue. But moving on, what dungeon shall I hit up? Clear two advanced dungeons. Yeah, might as well. How many tickets do I have? Three. Oh, this is where things get fun and interesting. Because this build works a lot better than I thought it would. Expert. Alright, we're good. Start 30. Yeah, screw that. I'm shooting this thing. I do like the fact that we can skip it, but what I don't like about skipping it is I don't reverse my switch. Yeah, screw you, Star. You know who I'm talking about. And I can't help but I like this music. They're trying to kill me. Okay, I did not expect it to finish that fast. I wouldn't be surprised if they made them I wouldn't say slightly weaker. If they let us drain his HP faster. Usually the fight lasts much longer than that, considering I did not pick up every missile. Not to mention, after watching this cutscene, I really should get my male mechanic up to 110. Should. Skirt! Starts my now. Let the fun begin. Oh hey, are you guys on fire yet? Oh Okay, they made that puzzle easier. Alright, we get it. You can stop nuking them already. Yeah, they took one off the puzzle. Don't you have confidence in me? Oh, look, he's burning. Mega Drill, yes. Use the drill. Ouch. Use the drill, that's I gotta get 10 seconds to drop this game. Okay, I just kind of wanted to do that. Explosion.
chest. Why my main element being water? I do a lot of crime, but then again, Dirge and Target's water and crime might as well be my second element. My dream deal would be to have, like, just not stop here. Oh, the grid cooled down. Okay, next. Soon as it's done, use again. But right now, having a 10-second delay is actually not bad. So what you trying to say? I get lost a lot?
Jump
always hurts.
And it's not just one damage that it hurts. Not does one hit and an extra.
I can undrag you now.
Oh, come! Really? 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 Jump, then land it immediately in the same spot again. Like the disrespect on that one, but news is the build works, because the build gives me Mega Drill every 16 seconds, but when the drill is done, I got 10 seconds before I can use another one. Once the drill is done, I got 10 seconds before I can use another one. push it even lower, but right now, most I can push it down to is 16 seconds. And yes, that includes having talismans on that team. So it's 31, but with those boots, that cooldown goes from 2 to 10%.